Hello friends, I welcome you to EPG Pathshala. My name is Dr. Amit Katoch and I am working as Assistant Professor in University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management of Punjab University. Dear students, I would be taking module number 13, that is Airport Management and Layout, Domestic and International. Under the paper, Aviation Industry, Ticketing and Frontier Formalities. After going through this module, the students would be able to learn about the airport management, benchmarking of the airports, layout of the airport, about the domestic airport, and about the international airport. Firstly, I would start with airport management and its benchmarking. Aviation sector is growing at a very fast rate. Also, there has been increased demand for air travel, and this has reiterated the requirement of efficient airport operations to facilitate the travelers and avoid congestion and delays in the air traffic system. The main airports acting as hub for a travel has been affected by congestion at the airports. The mammoth global growth in aviation sector has brought massive changes in the sector, and it is perceived that if only the global fleet of airlines doubles in 2 decades, the airports would grow and also its operation. It is projected that the airport congestion would become 3 times. Hence, proper management of airport is vital and mandatory. The role of an airport is not same from the local area, state, national and international viewpoint. Every airport is different from each other owing to different locations, operations, activities, limitations, ownership and governance structure. That is why every airport has various performance pointers which are vital and important for it. The government-owned non-profit airports have become performance indicators pointers than the case of private airports. These private airports give more emphasis on financial performance indicators. Similar case goes with the smaller and large airports where performance indicators are different. And the same thing goes with the green airports on large areas as compared to the urban airports which are located in urban areas and have many limitations. Also, the managers of the airport have different viewpoints or perceptions with regard to the performance indicators and may give preference to different performance indicators. Performance indicators are measures of outcomes of an airport by comparing them against the standardized set of values, which may be quantity, quality, input, process output, practical application, direction, action, and obviously financial aspects. There are key stages in identifying the key performance indicators and principally comprises a predefined business process, the need for business process, measuring the results qualitatively or quantitatively, by comparing them against set goals, and lastly seeing variances and changing procedure or assets to accomplish short-term objectives. Now I will discuss about the benchmarking of airports. Benchmarking is an important tool to understand and evaluate the present position of airports in relation to the best practices and to identify areas or means to improve performance. According to businessdictionary.com, benchmarking is a measurement of the quality of an organization's policies, programs, products, commerce strategies, etc., and their comparison with similar measurements of its peer group. It also helps to understand the present position of the airport and what improvements are required to achieve high performance levels. The airport benchmarking is broadly of 2 types, that is internal benchmarking or self benchmarking and external benchmarking or peer benchmarking. The former type of benchmarking compares performance of the airport from its own self, while the latter compares the performance of airport with other airports over a period of time. But whenever we are benchmarking, it has to be done very properly. Otherwise, it may not lead to desired results. Airports are very complicated entities and vary greatly from each other, whether it is in terms of passenger flows, businesses, regulations, airlines and managing tools. Each airport has a different organization structure, physical environment and financial aspects. And in order to compare the airports properly, it is important to compare the activities of the airport in a similar way. And the important factors which should be considered are blend of local and transfer travelers, passenger flows, airport traffic, number of terminals, common type of airline, type of airport, level of service, passenger door cargo activity, and types of scheduled and non-scheduled services. In internal benchmarking, the airport validates its performance by comparing itself. But it is simple, as the performance attributes are simple and do not vary. On the contrary, the external benchmarking is a complex activity, as the attributes of each airport are different. But in internal benchmarking, also at times the comparison drawn may not be easy. For example, the reduction in employment opportunities at an airport do not show that the passenger inflows and airport businesses have reduced. Also, the reduction in the number of employees does not tell that the management operating the airport is less efficient. The internal benchmarking has its own issues. Performance indicators, PI, are important but may have its own pitfalls. For example, when we compare the airports of Europe and USA for passenger per employee, the number of passengers per employee of Europe airports are less. But here it does not mean that the airports of Europe are less efficient, as the airports in Europe are labor intensive, that is having large ground staff as compared to US airports. Further, two airports may be similar in size but may have different passengers per employee. Now, what aspects could explain the difference? Maybe there is a difference in outsourcing of employees and the degree of service being given by the employees. The performance indicators other than passengers per employee are also very complicated, such as aeronautical revenue per employee. This variable has become a popular term but still has many complexities, as in some European airports, ground handling is a basic source of aeronautical revenue, but may not be in case of other airports. Hence, whenever we are comparing the European airports with other airports, it will show that the aeronautical revenue per passenger is on a higher side, though the exact results can only be got after segregating it. Also, there are other complications, as in some countries, taxes, environmental charges, ATC charges, and passenger-based charges are also part of aeronautical revenue passenger. Therefore, it is serious to segregate non-core constituents of aeronautical revenue to expand the quality of any PI comparisons. It is important to understand the aeronautical charges as a form of cost recovery, and the newly built airports will have high debt service costs and therefore lead to high aeronautical revenue per passenger. Generally, there are six main key performance areas or indicators for airports. Core. There are core measures used to describe and classify airports on the basis of passenger flows and the operations. In the short term, the airports do not have any control on them. Safety and security. This aspect is most important in the case of airports, and hence there is great classification with regard to the areas of the airport. Service quality. This performance indicator reflects the evolution of airport management, where great emphasis is given to facilities and operations, given to customers, and given competition to each other airports. Productivity / efficiency. This indicator measures the airport performance on the basis of efficiency measures and track output on the cost basis, that is, passengers per airport employee or departures for gate. Financial or commercial indicators. It measures the airport charges, financial strength, sustainability, and performance of individual commercial functions. ICAO also gives policies on charges for airports and air navigation services and states that performance management is an important tool for providers, users, and regulators. And as per minimum to unceasingly, performance is important in terms of key performance indicators. What is the quality of service quality, productivity, and cost effectiveness? Now I will discuss the layout of the airport. The layout of an airport involves an airport layout plan, that is ALP, which gives information about the current and prospective airport facilities present on the airport, and which also shows appropriate authorization and dimensional information required to show conformance with applicable standards. The LP represents, or the layout plan, that the optional position of the facilities which are forecasted as essential to launch the demand. ALP demonstrates development of required conveniences steady with forecast demand. The plan skeleton assists as a guide to the systematic and balanced perfections of the airport based on contemporary prognosis. The ALP or airport layout plans drawing set consists of airport layout plan, data sheet, terminal area plans, airport, a space drawing in a portion of the approaches, airport line use drawing, and airport property map. All the sites help in the critical planning of both the current facilities and the prospective development of an airport. The windows analysis helps in construction of runways with proper wind speed and taking into account safe landing aspects. Generally, wind coverage of 95% for 10.5 knots wind is there, then no crosswind runway is required. The construction of runway is also very technical aspect, which is constrained by land and wind. And various aspects are considered, such as magnetic variance, angle of runway, and designation of multiple runways is right or left. For the construction of airport, detailed analysis of site is done so that emphasis is on the length of runway, coordinates and elevations of runway, distance from the town or city, wind rose data, approach followed to make the runway, glide angle available, list of obstructions, existing zoning needed for the airport, availability of utilities, access road availability, and potential environmental impacts. Also, the site is analyzed from the viewpoint of engineering and construction factors, and obviously financial feasibility for the site. In terms of engineering and construction factors, the soil condition, the drainage pattern, the flora and fauna, grading factors, draining improvements, and general pavement design information and lighting aspects are seen. In case of financial viability, the total estimated cost of development and capital distribution between the center and state is also seen. The zoning around airport is also done so that issues like residential areas around the airport, arrival and departure areas in the airport, natural and man-made structures which interface with the flight, vibrations or fumes from the operation of the aircraft, and how to use the land on the airport is given importance. The airport houses all the sections which are necessary for the aviation industry, such as a taxi, cargo, military, corporate, emergency, medical and agriculture uses. Parallel taxiways are vital in airport as they increase the productivity or efficiency and reduce flight delays. The airport has a system of wide parallel and linking taxiways which are 50 foot wide. The TAP, that is Terminal Area Plan, realistically describes the current and futuristic layout of facilities in the terminal area, such as structures, apron, parking areas, etc. The drawing showcases the position and location of the present money-making areas, that is the commercial areas, and overall aviation facilities and the related expansion and progression. The terminal building acts as a gateway to the community. The airport planning comprises airport master plan, airport layout plan, windrows analysis and runway designation. The various elements of an airport master plan includes airport master plan, environmental considerations, existing conditions, aviation forecast, facility requirement, alternative development and evaluation, airport layout plans, facilities, implementation plan and financial feasibility analysis. Now I will discuss about the master plan. The planners or owners depend on airport master plan for the airport development. An airport master plan is a blueprint for long-term development of an airport. It helps in graphic representation of current airport attributes, development of airport in future and expected land use. It helps in creating a genuine schedule for the execution of the anticipated development. It also helps in recognizing and genuine financial plan to maintain development. It helps in authenticating the plan theoretically and procedurally by examining the various notions and giving plan B, which is the substitute on the ground of ecology, economy and other technical aspects. It helps in presentation and preparation of a plan which satisfies all the stakeholders of an airport and addresses the important subject and fulfills all the regulations, whether national or international. The International Civil Aviation Organization, that is ICAO, also provides plans under its manuals to give an exact and logical idea for the formulation of an airport plan. It considers all type of development, whether long term or short term, and giving emphasis to all social, economic and environmental aspects while adjusting aviation. Airport master planning process involves the number of steps such as setting the goals, coordinative or policy planning, economic planning, physical planning, environmental planning, financial planning and reviewing. The airport terminal complex comprises three broad categories, such as terminal facilities, terminal building facilities and landside terminal facilities. The airside terminal facilities comprises various components such as aircraft parking, taxiway and taxi lanes, terminal gates, apron area, common ground service equipment, staging and movement area, aircraft servicing area, security and emergency response, environmental aspects and the various operations such as dicing, apron snow removal, among these. The terminal building facilities comprises concessions, terminal facility requirements such as ticketing, checking, procedure, screening, hold rooms, confessions, baggage claim area, airline offices, baggage handling area, baggage screening system, support areas, concourses, and building systems. The landside terminal facilities helps in maintaining efficiency and positively impacting the thoughts process of a traveler. It provides an interface between airport and regional ground transportation system. The various elements which constitute the landside terminal facilities are the curb front, pedestrian crosswalks, car parking areas, entry or exit roadways, commercial vehicle or target staging area, all rail transits. The terminal project vary by an airport size, which may be large, medium or small, having air terminals. The air terminal planning projects involve analysis of present inventory data, conceptual and alternative evaluation of terminal concepts, and selection of favorite or best alternative plan for further development. The proper steps are taken while developing an airport, whether it is new, to be renovated or to be extended. But having a synergistic relationship between qualitative aspects and technical analysis. The procedural and imaginative services which are used in terminal planning and designating the airport are of four main types, that is, facility programming, planning, design, and specialized technical analysis. Now I will discuss about the domestic airport. Domestic airport is a type of airport that caters to the need of domestic air travelers within the same country. It does not have customs and immigration facilities, and that's why it cannot handle foreign airport services. Normally, these airports have short runways to handle short or medium haul flights for the local and regional air traffic. Some countries only have international airport and do not have domestic airports due to their size or maybe some political reasons, such as Kuwait, Macau, Belgium, etc. Though in some countries the airports not present in capitals or major cities are classified as regional airports, such as Manchester Airport in England or Barcelona El Prat Airport in Spain. In some countries such as Sweden, Germany and France, airports serve small planes are categorized as regional domestic airports. In India, the airports which are exclusively working as domestic airports are Lok Nayak Jayaprakash Airport in Patna, Bihar, Swami Vivekananda Airport in Raipur, Chhattisgarh, Birsa Munda Airport in Ranchi, Jharkhand, Maharana Pratap Airport, Udaipur, Rajasthan, Nazi Nazrul Islam Airport in Durgapur, that is West Bengal, and Kuzuk Bakula Rinpoche Airport in Leh, Jammu and Kashmir. Now I will discuss about the international airports. International airports are a type of airport which offers passengers travel to outbound and inbound travelers which go from India and come from abroad. These airports have customs and immigration facilities for the passengers who are traveling from one country to the other. These are larger airports than the domestic airport and have long runways and facilities to cater the needs of international travelers. These airports provide all the facilities, including the modern facilities to the passengers. Hounslow Heath Aerodrome, which was the first airport to operate scheduled air service. The precursors to international airports were aerodromes or airfields. Sometimes these airports also served military purpose other than the commercial purpose. The international airports primarily function as hubs from where the flights may go to regional areas. Non-direct flight go to other main hubs or other cities. Point-to-point direct flights. These airports have modern baggage handling facilities to deal with international travel. Some of the famous international airports are such as Heathrow Airport in London, Charles de Gaulle Airport in Paris, John F. Kennedy International Airport in New York, Indira Gandhi International Airport in Delhi, and Juraj International Airport in Mexico City, etc. Now I would like to summarize the whole module. Aviation sector is growing at a very fast rate. Also, there have been increased demand for air travel. The mammoth global growth in aviation sector has brought massive changes in the sector, and it is perceived that if only the global fleet of airlines double in 2 decades, the airport would grow and also its operations. It is projected that the airport congestion would become 3 times. Hence, proper management of airport is vital and mandatory. The role of an airport is not same from the local area, state, national and international viewpoint. Every airport is different from each other owing to different locations, operations, activities, limitations, ownership and governance structure. Benchmarking is an important tool to understand and evaluate the present position of airports in relation to the best practices and to identify areas or means to improve performance. The airport benchmarking is broadly of 2 types. The internal or self benchmarking compares performance of the airport from its own self, while the external or peer benchmarking compares the performance of airport with other airports over a period of time. The layout of an airport involves an airport layout plan, that is airport layout plan, which gives information about the current and prospective airport facilities present on the airport and which also shows appropriate authorization and dimensional information required to show conformance with applicable standards. An airport master plan is a blueprint for long-term development of an airport. Airport master planning process involves the number of steps such as setting the goals, coordinative planning, economic planning, physical planning, environmental planning, financial planning, and reviewing. Domestic airport is a type of airport that caters to the need of domestic air travelers within the same country, while international airport is a type of airport which offers passenger travel to outbound and inbound travelers which go from India and come from abroad. These airports have customs and immigration facilities for the passengers who are traveling from one country to the other. At the end of the module, I would like to say that success in airport management requires learning as fast as the world is changing. Thank you and have a nice day.